Christmas time is here, by golly, disapproval would be folly. Deck the halls with hunks of holly, fill the cup and don't say when. Kill the turkeys, ducks, and chickens, mix the punch, drag out the dickens. Even though the prospect sickens, brother, here we go again. On Christmas Day, you can't get sore. Your fellow man you must adore. There's time to rob him all the more. The other 306, a T, a 4. Relations, sparing no expense'll, send some useless old utensil, or a matching pen and pencil, just the thing I need. How nice. It doesn't matter how sincere it is, nor how heartfelt the spirit. Sentiment will not endear it. What's important is the price. Hark, the Herald Tribune sings, advertising wondrous things. God rest ye merry merchants, may ye make the Yuletide pay. Angels we have heard on high tell us to go out and buy. So let the raucous sleigh bells jingle, hail our dear old friend Kris Kringle, driving his reindeer across the sky. Don't stand underneath when they fly by.
That's the Boy Scouts marching song, be prepared. As through life you march along, be prepared to hold your liquor pretty well. Don't write naughty words on walls if you can't spell. Be prepared to hide that pack of cigarettes. Don't make book if you cannot cover bets. Keep those reefers hidden where you're sure that they will not be found. And be careful not to smoke them when the scoutmaster's around, for he only will insist that they be shared. Be prepared. Be prepared. That's the Boy Scout's solemn creed. Be prepared. And be clean in word and deed. Don't solicit for your sister, that's not nice, unless you get a good percentage of her price. Be prepared, and be careful not to do your good deeds when there's no one watching you. If you're looking for adventure of a new and different kind, and you come across a Girl Scout who is similarly inclined, don't be nervous, don't be flustered, don't be scared. Be prepared.
Bright college days, oh carefree days that fly, to thee we sing with our glasses raised on high. Let's drink a toast as each of us recalls ivy-covered professors in ivy-covered halls. Turn on the spigot, pour the beer and swig it, and Gaudeamus igit a tour. Here's to parties we tossed, to the games that we lost. We shall claim that we won them someday. To the girls young and sweet, to the spacious back seat of our roommate's beat-up Chevrolet. To the beer and Benzedrine, to the way that the dean tried so hard to be pals with us all. To excuses we fibbed, to the papers we cribbed from the genius who lived down the hall. To the tables down at Maury's, wherever that may be. Let us drink a toast to all we love the best. We will sleep through all the lectures and cheat on the exams, and we'll pass and be forgotten with the rest. Oh, soon we'll be out amid the cold world's strife. Soon we'll be sliding down the razor blade of life. Ooh. But as we go our sordid separate ways, we shall ne'er forget thee, thou golden college days. Hearts full of youth, hearts full of truth, 6 parts gin to 1 part vermouth. Demonstrate to them our skill, albeit they possess the might. Nonetheless, we have the will. How we will celebrate our victory, we shall invite the whole team up for tea. How jolly! Hurl that spheroid down the field and fight, fight, fight. Impress them with our prowess, do. Oh, fellows, do not let the crimson down. Be of stout heart and true. Come on, chaps, fight for Harvard's glorious name. Won't it be peachy if we win the game? Oh, goody, let's try not to injure them. But fight, 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 let's not be rough, though. Fight, 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 and do fight fiercely. Fight, fight, fight. Dainty fingertips. My joy would be complete, dear, if you were only here. But still I keep your hand as a precious souvenir. The night you died, I cut it off. I really don't know why. Now each time I kiss it, I get blood stains on my tie. I'm sorry now I killed you, for our love was something fine. Until they come to get me, I shall hold your hand.
Dixie, take me back to dear old Dixie. That's the only little old place for little old me. Old times they are not forgotten, whooping slaves and selling cotton and waiting for the Robert E. Lee. It was never there on time. I'll go back to the Swanee, where pellagra makes you scrawny and the honeysuckle clutters up the vine. I really am a fixin' to go home and start a mixin' down below that Mason-Dixon line. Oh, poll tax, how I love you, my dear old poll tax. Won't you come with me to Alabama, back to the arms of my dear old mammy? Her cooking's lousy and her hands are clammy, but what the hell, it's home. Yes, for paradise, the Southland is my nominee. Just give me a ham hock and a grit of hominy. I wanna go back to Dixie. I wanna be a Dixie Bixie and eat corn pone till it's coming out of my ears. I wanna talk with Southern gentlemen and put my white sheet on again. I ain't seen one good lynching in years. The land of the boll weevil, where the laws are medieval, is calling me to come and nevermore roam. I wanna go back to the Southland, that you all and shut my mouth land. Be it ever so decadent, there's no place like home. Thank you.
time in Guadalajara. Then I long to be back once again in old Mexico, where we lived for today, never giving a thought to tomorrow. To the strumming of guitars in 100 grubby bars, I would whisper te amo. The mariachis would serenade, and they would not shut up till they were paid. We ate, we drank, and we were merry, and we got typhoid and dysentery. Oh, but best of all, we went to the Plaza de Toros. Now whenever I start feeling morose, I revive by recalling that scene. And names like Belmonte, Dominguín, and Manolete, if I live to 180, I shall never forget what they mean. There is surely nothing more beautiful in this world than the sight of a lone man facing single-handedly a half a ton of angry pot roast. Out came the matador, who must have been potted or slightly insane, but who looked rather bored. Then the picadors, of course, each one on his horse. I shouted hooray every time one was gored. I cheered at the banderilleros' display as they stuck the bull in their own clever way, for I hadn't had so much fun since the day my brother's dog Rover got run over. Rover was killed by a Pontiac, and it was done with such grace and artistry that the witnesses awarded the driver both ears and the tail. But I digress. The moment had come, I swallowed my gum. We knew there'd be blood on the sand pretty soon. The crowd held its breath, hoping that death would brighten an otherwise dull afternoon. At last, the matador did what we wanted him to. He raised his sword and his aim was true. In that moment of truth, I suddenly knew that someone had stolen my wallet. Now it's fiesta time in Akron, Ohio. But it's back to old Guadalajara I'm longing to go. Far away from the strikes of the AF of L and CIO. How I wish I could get back to the land of the wetback and forget the Alamo in old Mexico. Hola! The heart of every man in our platoon must swell with pride for the nation's youth, the cream of which is marching at his side, for the fascinating rules and regulations that we share, and the quaint and curious costumes that we're called upon to wear. Now Al joined up to do his part, defending you and me. He wants to fight and bleed and kill and die for liberty. With the hell of war, he's come to grips, policing up the filter tips. It makes a fella proud to be a soldier. When Pete was only in the 7th grade, he stabbed a cop. He's real RA material, and he was glad to swap his switchblade and his old zip gun for a bayonet and a new M1. It makes a fella proud to be a soldier. After Johnny got through basic training, he was a soldier through and through when he was done. Its effects were so well rooted that the next day he saluted a good humor man, an usher, and a nun. Now Fred's an intellectual, brings a book to every meal. He likes the deep philosophers, like Norman Vincent Peale. He thinks the army's just the thing because he finds it broadening. It makes a fella proud to be a soldier. Now Ed flunked out of second grade and never finished school. He doesn't know a shelter half from an entrenching tool, but he's going to be a big success. He heads his class at OCS. It makes a fella proud to be a soldier. Our old mess sergeant's taste buds had been shot off in the war, but his savory collations add to our esprit de corps. To think of all the marvelous ways they're using plastics nowadays, it makes a fella proud to be a soldier. Our lieutenant is the up-and-coming type. Played with soldiers as a boy, you just can bet. It is written in the stars, he will get his captain's bars, but he hasn't got enough box tops yet. Our captain has a handicap to cope with, sad to tell. He's from Georgia, and he doesn't speak the language very well. He used to be, so rumor has, the dean of men at Alcatraz. It makes a fella proud to be what as a kid I vowed to be. What luck to be allowed to be a soldier. At ease. Who made me the genius I am today? The mathematician that others all quote? Who's the professor that made me that way? The greatest that ever got chalk on his coat. One man deserves the credit, one man deserves the blame, and Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky is his name. Hi, Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky. I am never forget the day I first meet the great Lobachevsky. In one word, he told me the secret of success in mathematics. Plagiarize. Plagiarize. Let no one else's work evade your eyes. Remember why the good Lord made your eyes, so don't shade your eyes, but plagiarize, plagiarize, plagiarize. Only be sure always to call it, please, research. And ever since I meet this man, my life is not the same. And Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky is his name. Hi, Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky. I am never forget the day I'm given first original paper to write. It was on analytic and algebraic topology of local Euclidean metrization of infinitely differentiable Riemannian manifold. Boże moi. This I know from nothing. What I'm going to do. I think of great Lobachevsky and I get idea. I have a friend in Minsk who has a friend in Pinsk, whose friend in Omsk has friend in Tomsk with friend in Akmolinsk. His friend in Alexandrovsk has friend in Petropavlovsk, whose friend somehow is solving now the problem in Dnipropetrovsk. And when his work is done, ha-ha, begins the fun. From Dnipropetrovsk to Petropavlovsk, by way of Ilyinsk and Novorossiysk, to Alexandrovsk, to Akmolinsk, to Tomsk, to Omsk, to Pinsk, to Minsk, to me the news will run. Yes, to me the news will run. And then I write by morning, night, and afternoon, and pretty soon my name in Dnipropetrovsk is cursed when he finds out I publish first. And who made me a big success and brought me wealth and fame? Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky is his name. Hi, Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky. I am never forget the day my first book is published. Every chapter I stole from somewhere else. Index I copy from old Vladivostok telephone directory. This book was sensational. Pravda. Well, Pravda said Gilbil Kalorika dat prinyom lachajila. It stinks. But Izvestia. Izvestia said, Ya idu kuda sam tsar idiot peshkom. It stinks. Metro Goldwyn Moskva buys the movie rights for 6 million rubles, changing title to The Eternal Triangle, with Ingrid Bergman playing part of Hypotenuse. And who deserves the credit? And who deserves the blame? Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky is his name. Hey! I really have a yen. once again, back to the place where no one wears a frown, to see once more those super special, just plain folks in my hometown. No fella could ignore the little girl next door. She sure looked sweet in her first evening gown. Now there's a charge for what she used to give for free in my hometown. I remember Dan, the druggist on the corner. He was never mean or ornery, he was swell. He killed his mother-in-law and ground her up real well, and sprinkled just a bit over each banana split. The guy that taught us math, who never took a bath, acquired a certain measure of renown. And after school, he sold the most amazing pictures in my hometown. That fellow was no fool who taught our Sunday school, and neither was our kindly Parson Brown. I guess I better leave this line out just to be on the safe side. In my hometown, I remember Sam. He was the village idiot, and though it seems a pity, it was so. He loved to burn down houses just to watch the glow. And nothing could be done because he was the mayor's son. The guy that took a knife and monogrammed his wife, then dropped her in the pond and watched her drown. Oh yes, indeed, the people there are just plain folks in my hometown. From the Bible to the popular song, there's one theme that we find right along. Of all ideals they hail as good, the most sublime is motherhood. There was a man, though, who it seems once carried this ideal to extremes. He loved his mother and she loved him, and yet his story is rather grim. Once lived a man named Oedipus Rex. You may have heard about his odd complex. His name appears in Freud's index, 'cause he loved his mother. His rivals used to say quite a bit that as a monarch he was most unfit, but still and all they had to admit that he loved his mother. Yes, he loved his mother like no other. His daughter was his sister and his son was his brother. One thing on which you can depend is he sure knew who a boy's best friend is. When he found what he had done, he tore his eyes out one by one. A tragic end to a loyal son who loved his mother. So be sweet and kind to mother, now and then have a chat. Buy her candy or some flowers or a brand new hat. But maybe you had better let it go at that, or you may find yourself with a quite complex complex, and you may end up like Oedipus. I'd rather marry a duck-billed platypus than end up like old Oedipus Rex. Here, a suffering is here. Life is skittles and life is beer. I think the loveliest time of the year is the spring. I do, don't you? Of course you do. But there's one thing that makes spring complete for me, and makes every Sunday a treat for me. All the world seems in tune on a spring afternoon when we're poisoning pigeons in the park. Every Sunday you'll see my sweetheart and me as we poison the pigeons in the park. When they see us coming, the birdies all try and hide, but they still go for peanuts when coated with cyanide. The sun's shining bright, everything seems all right when we're poisoning pigeons in the park. La 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 do. We've gained notoriety and caused much anxiety in the Audubon Society with our games. They call it impiety and lack of propriety and quite a variety of unpleasant names. But it's not against any religion to want to dispose of a pigeon. So if Sunday you're free, why don't you come with me and we'll poison the pigeons in the park? And maybe we'll do in a squirrel or two while we're poisoning pigeons in the park. We'll murder them all amid laughter and merriment, except for the few we take home to experiment. My pulse will be quickening with each drop of strychnine we feed to a pigeon. It just takes a smidgen to poison a pigeon in the park. Selling out is easy to do. It's not so hard to find a buyer for you. When money talks, you're under its spell. Ah, but what do you have when there's nothing left to sell? Selling out,
I'd rather call it compromise,
is easy to do.
Sometimes you have to close your eyes.
It's not so hard.
Being rich is no disgrace,
to find a buyer for you.
Put on your shoes and join the race.
When money talks,
it has a very soothing voice.
You're under its spell.
It's up to you to make the choice.
Ah, but what do
you
have when there's nothing left to sell? Always break the rules. People who try are fools. When you get older, maybe then you will see. I've always found ideals don't take the place of meals. That's how it is and how it will always be. It's so nice to have integrity. I'll tell you why. If you really have integrity, it means your price is very high. So remember when you start to preach and moralize, that we all are in the game, and brother, its name is compromise. It's so nice
selling
to have integrity.
I'll tell you why.
It's nice to have integrity. So remember when you start,
it's your
dream. You're under it, so
just as you make the choice.
Now that we all are on the game,
now we know
there is nothing left to sell.
Sharks gotta swim and bats gotta fly. I gotta love one woman till I die. To Ed or Dick or Bob, she may be just a slob, but to me, well, she's my girl. In winter, the bedroom is one large ice cube, and she squeezes the toothpaste from the middle of the tube. Her hair's in the sink, have driven me to drink, but she's my girl. She's my girl. She's my girl. And I love her. The girl that I lament for, the girl my money's spent for, the girl my back is bent for, the girl I owe the rent for, the girl I gave up Lent for, is the girl that heaven meant for me. So though
coffee that tastes like shampoo. I come home for dinner and get peanut butter stew. Or if I'm in luck, it's broiled hockey puck. But oh well, what the hell, she's my girl, and I love her. There's antimony, arsenic, aluminum, selenium, and hydrogen, and oxygen, and nitrogen, and rhenium, and nickel, neodymium, neptunium, germanium, and iron, americium, ruthenium, uranium, europium, zirconium, lutetium, vanadium, and lanthanum, and osmium, and astatine, and radium, and gold, protactinium, and indium, and gallium, and iodine, and thorium, and thulium, and thallium. There's yttrium, ytterbium, actinium, rubidium, and boron, gadolinium, niobium, iridium, and strontium, and silicon, and silver, and samarium, and bismuth, bromine, lithium, beryllium, and barium. There's holmium and helium and hafnium and erbium and phosphorus and francium and fluorine and terbium and manganese and mercury, molybdenum, magnesium, dysprosium and scandium and cerium and cesium and lead, praseodymium and platinum, plutonium, palladium, promethium, potassium, polonium and tantalum, technetium, titanium, tellurium and cadmium and calcium and chromium and curium. There's sulfur, californium, and fermium, berkelium, and also mendelevium, einsteinium, nobelium, and argon, kryptonian, radon, xenon, zinc, and rhodium, and chlorine, carbon, cobalt, copper, tungsten, tin, and sodium. These are the only ones of which the news has come to Harvard. And there may be many others, but they haven't been discovered. November, I went out to hunt some deer on a morning bright and clear. I went and shot the maximum the game laws would allow, 2 game wardens, 7 hunters, and a cow. I was in no mood to trifle, I took down my trusty rifle and went out to stalk my prey. What a haul I made that day. I tied them to my fender and I drove them home somehow, 2 game wardens, 7 hunters, and a cow. The law was very firm, it took away my permit, the worst punishment I ever endured. It turned out there was a reason, cows were out of season, and one of the hunters wasn't insured. People ask me how I do it, and I say there's nothing to it. You just stand there looking cute, and when something moves, you shoot. And there's 10 stuffed heads in my trophy room right now. 2 game wardens, 7 hunters, and a purebred Guernsey cow. About a maid I'll sing a song, sing rickety-tickety-tin. About a maid I'll sing a song who didn't have her family long. Not only did she do them wrong, she did every one of them in, she did every one of them in. One morning in a fit of pique, sing rickety-tickety-tin. One morning in a fit of pique, she drowned her father in the creek. The water tasted bad for a week, and we had to make do with gin, with gin. We had to make do with gin. Her mother, she could never stand, sing rickety-tickety-tin. Her mother, she could never stand, and so a cyanide soup she planned. The mother died with a spoon in her hand, and her face in a hideous grin, a grin. Her face in a hideous grin. She set her sister's hair on fire, rickety-tickety-tin. She set her sister's hair on fire, and as the smoke and flame rose higher, danced around the funeral pyre, playing a violin, olin, playing a violin. She weighted her brother down with stones, rickety-tickety-tin. She weighted her brother down with stones and sent him off to Davy Jones. All they ever found were some bones.
and occasional pieces of skin, of skin, occasional pieces of skin. One day when she had nothing to do, rickety-tickety-tin, one day when she had nothing to do, she cut her baby brother in two and served him up as an Irish stew and invited the neighbors in, boys in, invited the neighbors in. And when at last the police came by, rickety-tickety-tin, and when at last the police came by, her little pranks she did not deny. To do so she would have had to lie, and lying she knew was a sin, a sin, lying she knew was a sin. My tragic tale I won't prolong, rickety-tickety-tin, my tragic tale I won't prolong, and if you do not enjoy my song, you've yourselves to blame if it's too long. You should never have let me begin, begin, you should never have let me begin.
For the touch of your lips, dear, but much more for the touch of your whips, dear. You can raise welts like nobody else as we dance to the masochism tango. Let our love be a flame, not an ember. Say it's me that you want to dismember. Blacken my eye, set fire to my tie as we dance to the masochism tango. At your command, before you here I stand, my heart is in my hand. Ugh. It's here that I must be. My heart entreats, just hear those savage beats, and go put on your cleats, and come and trample me. Your heart is hard as stone or mahogany, that's why I'm in such exquisite agony. My soul is on fire, it's aflame with desire, which is why I perspire when we tango. You caught my nose in your left castanet, love. I can feel the pain yet, love, every time I hear drums. And I envy the rose that you held in your teeth, love, with the thorns underneath, love, sticking into your gums. Your eyes cast a spell that bewitches. The last time I needed 20 stitches to sew up the gash that you made with your lash as we dance to the masochism tango. Bash in my brain and make me scream with pain, then kick me once again and say we'll never part. I know too well I'm underneath your spell, so darling, if you smell something burning, it's my heart. Excuse me. Take your cigarette from its holder and burn your initials in my shoulder. Fracture my spine and swear that you're mine as we dance to the masochism tango.
Of night are falling, comes a fellow everyone knows. It's the old dope peddler spreading joy wherever he goes. Every evening you will find him around our neighborhood. It's the old dope peddler, doing well by doing good. He gives the kids free samples because he knows full well that today's young innocent faces will be tomorrow's clientele. Here's a cure for all your troubles. Here's an end to all distress. It's the old dope peddler with his powdered happiness. Waltz. The music was gay and the setting was Viennese. Your hair wore some roses, or perhaps they were peonies. I was blind to your obvious faults. As we danced across the scene to the strains of the Wiener Schnitzel Waltz. Oh, I drank some champagne from your shoe. La la la, I was drunk by the time I got through. La la la, for I didn't know as I raised that cup, it had taken two bottles to fill the thing up. It was I who stepped on your dress. La la la, the skirts all came off, I confess. La la la, revealing for all of the others to see just what it was that endeared you to me. I remember the night I held you so tight as we danced to the Wiener Schnitzel Waltz. Your lips were like wine, if you'll pardon the simile. The music was lovely and quite Rudolph Frimley. I drank wine, you drank chocolate malts. And we both turned quite green to the strains of the Wiener Schnitzel Waltz. Spaces are wide open in the land of the old AEC.
Yahoo!
Where the scenery's attractive and the air is radioactive. Oh, the Wild West is where I wanna be. Mid the sagebrush and the cactus, I'll watch the fellas practice dropping bombs through the clean desert breeze.
Yahoo!
I'll have on my sombrero, and of course I'll wear a pair of Levi's over my lead BVDs. I will leave the city's rush, leave the fancy and the plush, leave the snow and leave the slush and the crowds. I will seek the desert's hush where the scenery is lush. How I long to see the mush room of clouds. Mid the yuccas and the thistles, I'll watch the guided missiles while the old FBI watches me.
Yahoo!
Yes, I'll soon make my appearance, soon as I can get my clearance, cause the Wild West is where I wanna be.
It is sad to think that sooner or later those you love will do the same for you. And you may have thought it tragic, not to mention other adjectives, 'Tis to think of all the weeping they will do, but don't you worry. No more ashes, no more sackcloth, and an armband made of black cloth will someday nevermore adorn a sleeve. For if the bomb that drops on you gets your friends and neighbors too, there'll be nobody left behind to grieve, and we will all go together when we go. What a comforting fact that is to know. Universal bereavement, an inspiring achievement. Yes, we all will go together when we go. We will all go together when we go. All suffused with an incandescent glow. No one will have the endurance to collect on his insurance. Lloyd's of London will be loaded when they go. We will all fry together when we fry. We'll be French fried potatoes by and by. There will be no more misery when the world is our rotisserie. Yes, we all will fry together when we fry. Down by the old maelstrom, there'll be a storm before the calm, and we will all bake together when we bake. There'll be nobody present at the wake, with complete participation in that grand incineration, nearly 3 billion hunks of well-done steak. Oh, we will all char together when we char, and let there be no moaning of the bar. Just sing out a Te Deum when you see that ICBM, and the party will be come as you are. We will all burn together when we burn. There'll be no need to stand and wait your turn. When it's time for the fallout and St. Peter calls us all out, we'll just drop our agendas and adjourn. You will all go directly to your respective Valhallas. Go directly, do not pass, go, do not collect $200. And we will all go together when we go. Every Hottentot and every Eskimo, when the air becomes uranious, we will all go simultaneous. Yes, we all will go together when we all go together. Yes, we all will go together when we go. Since I still appreciate you, let's find love while we may. Because I know I'll hate you when you are old and gray. So say you love me here and now, I'll make the most of that. Say you love and trust me, for I know you'll disgust me when you're old and getting fat. And utility, a loss of mobility is a strong possibility. In all probability, I'll lose my virility, and you your fertility and desirability. And this liability of total sterility will lead to hostility and a sense of futility. So let's act with agility while we still have facility, for we'll soon reach senility and lose the ability. Your teeth will start to go, dear. Your waist will start to spread. In 20 years or so, dear, I'll wish that you were dead. I'll never love you then at all the way I do today. So please remember when I leave in December, I told you so in May.